Hello, Jang here from JANGBRiCKS.com with a look at a Mega Bloks Halo mid-year 2014 set release. This is the UNSC Broadsword Midnight Strike, and it comes with 716 pieces officially, includes the Didact and the new version of Master Chief and a new version, of Cortana. First off, the Broadsword itself, you notice it's on a transparent stand. That is included, all those pieces, plus a few extra transparent pieces are included with this set. Thank goodness, they are so useful for display, especially if you're really proud of your collection. It's nice to put the aircraft up in the air, spacecraft up above the ground, above the surface. So that's a nice display feature. The Broadsword itself, you know, me personally, in game, I thought it was an ugly looking thing. I loved flying it around. I loved flying it around quite a bit, but I just don't think that it's good looking. I think it looks good from the top, but from most other angles, not so much so. It's got such a hump back and so much bulk in the middle and just strange shapes to me. I much preferred the saber. That said, Mega Bloks has done a pretty darn good job of emulating the design of the thing without adding in a bunch of new pieces. I think that the canopy piece is new. And beyond that, I didn't recognize much. I'm not too familiar with some of their other series of other different franchises that they make stuff for. I don't know if some of these curve pieces were used before, but for the most part, this is built using existing Mega Bloks pieces. I feel like they captured the shapes, all the important shapes, pretty well here. And the big surprises for me are in play features included with this set, because it's got the missile launchers that can actually shoot missiles. These on the sides, you squeeze down from underneath. There's a little, like a little plate, and you just squeeze on it. You can attach things to it if you like. And oops, there we go. Here we go. Do it again faster. Yeah, see, works very well. And this is the little projectile. You get a couple extras of these as well. You get one launcher on either side. The cannons, little cannons, are on the sides down here, as they should be. And the extra ammo is included inside. You can take this whole roof section off. That's new for small craft. You can see there, you got the two spares. And then all of this is a little weapons platform that you can take out and use separately. These are all extra minifig weapons that are included with the set. So left to right, it's a sticky detonator. Then you've got a grenade launcher, shotgun, and a saw. They are all molded in black, and you see the stand, even though it's built or designed to be fit into that bay on the top of the plane, still stands on the ground and looks good. Putting this back on, let's move on to the next thing that can open up the cockpit. Of course, it holds just one single figure. It's a bit of a tight squeeze with the new figures. They're more bulky than before, but does still just squeeze in there with the arms along the sides. A little bit tough to angle this up to let you see the canopy, or excuse me, the console on the front. That's just a single sticker. Bunch of stickers used around this whole thing for small details, not really critical details for the most part. You just kind of see small things. The instructions are terrible for the stickers. They show you where things go, but they give you the wrong numbers for most of them. The majority of them have the wrong numbers on them, but you can clearly see what goes where. And on some of them, like these here, you have to actually look at the shapes of the die cuts of the stickers themselves to see where they will end up fitting. It doesn't look quite the same as it does on the box art. And oh yeah, the stand is connected with no studs. That's just a smooth surface there. It just sits on top of it. Another thing that's divergent from the box art is the pair of your afterburner outlets back there. They're black. They're actually molded in black on the box. It shows them being molded in gold, similar to the way they are in game. I think it looks just fine in black, personally. This is a production version. I did buy it from a regular store, so it's not a variant that I'm aware of. What else do we have going on? You got your little different flaps, which can be extended out, air brakes style flaps, or they might be used for a little bit of differential, drag to help the maneuverability of the whole thing. You can adjust the angles of these tail surfaces, bring these down, bring these up, or you can just leave them posed, you know, however you want those to be. The wings themselves are not moving around. They're completely rigid. One other feature down here, oh yeah, engine inlets on the sides. Big old inlet section under here. Nice reuse of parts there. And you get the big Havoc missile with the warhead built onto it. Doesn't always come off exactly where you want. You know, you ideally you would want to keep the black pieces and leave the silver behind, but you know, it, you can still make it work. The warhead, the Havoc warhead itself, is just this tip piece, but it's nice to have that on there and nice to have it be a removable thing that can be used by younger kids who might get a set like this and want to actually play with it and fire that thing off or drop it. I do want to point out that there's a lot of upside down building done on this, so you can see pieces were added this way. They go from right side up to upside down a bunch of times. You flip the center section around. Has really uses those nice direction changer pieces that only Mega Bloks has to great effect. Makes it a lot easier to build the things. It's a fairly simple build, even though there are a lot of tricks like that to the whole thing. It goes together in a pretty straightforward way, and thanks to the improved parts quality for 2014, things go together pretty straight. There are only a few things here that didn't go together all that well, as far as like leaving gaps behind. You can see right in here, this piece has to be kind of squished back in, and it tends to kind of bend itself back. That's not a new piece. I could tell from the texture. They're still getting some of the old parts out of the hopper, out of the queue, if you will. So you will still be getting some older pieces with at least these first production runs for the new set. So that's, you know, it's just something we'll have to deal with for a little while. But most of the pieces on this set are new for 2014 and went together very well, smoothly, nice and flat, and without any hassle whatsoever. Took about 3 hours from opening the box to being completely done with this whole set. One special thing about the stickers on the broadsword, I've left out the vertical stabilizer stickers because they come with a bunch of them. A bunch of different ones. You can choose which emblems, which insignias, which badges to place on either side. I started thinking about, okay, which one, which set am I going to use, which is my favorite? And I said, you know what? I'm not even gonna choose. I'm gonna let you, the viewer, choose. Please post up a comment about what you think about this whole set once you're done watching the video, and then select which insignia you would like me to put on, and I will put those stickers on, whichever insignia gets the most votes in the comment section will be placed onto this set, and you will see those stickers on this set in a later video. So you can either describe which one that you like by what it looks like, or just call it out by its official title. Now, the figures in this set are a big deal. Master Chief, Official, Didact, and a new Cortana full-sized figure. Naturally, we need to start with the Didact. This is a pretty unique thing in that this is pretty much a regular sized action figure. It's not really a minifigure when you do them properly to scale, which they have done. Really puts into perspective just how tall the Forerunners were, and the Didact in his full armor especially. You know, you see it in the game, but you don't see it for all that long, and it almost feels surreal during the campaign. But this really puts it into perspective. It's just such a tall figure, and it's well detailed. They didn't just, you know, just put together something quick with a few molds. They went full on, did a proper full on replica as best they could to scale with the Mega Bloks figures in general, and fitting with the ability to stand on a studded base, and he can also hold on to standard Mega Bloks weapons. Works best with staff style weapons, anything that's long, but it does fit with the standard system. They tried to get the little kind of floaty bits sticking out from them in a few places. I think they did a pretty admirable job without making the thing fragile. The figure has ball joints in the shoulders, so there's a little bit of limitation there, a little bit like the older style, but still gives you a good range. You can go full back, full forward, and you just can't come across the chest quite as much until you rotate. Still limited, but you can rotate the elbow joint because it has a rotation on two axes. So they got kind of half of the new articulation from the new minifigures in there. It's got the ability to rotate at the waist, and then also gets ball joints in the hips for the upper thigh, and then you get just a regular single axis joint for the knee. So you're able to get a lot of posability out of this thing. Just not quite able to get the head to turn down. I wish that the head could really turn down to look down a little bit more effectively, you know, down directly on top of a smaller figure in front of it. If you're wondering if he can do this, yes, he can do this. Doesn't quite bring the figure up all the way to eye level. That's a little bit tougher. Just would need a little bit more articulation to make that possible, but you know, you can kind of get it there. It does, you can see it does have enough friction in the shoulder joint to hold that up. So you can kind of get it close to what we got in the game, in the cutscene, just a little bit off. I'm sure that some folks would be able to put a little bit more time into getting this right and make it look even more believable. Well, that's great that you can do that at all. And I'm sure that was an intentional design decision. Here's a better look at the new Master Chief with the new articulation. You can check out my separate video again covering all of the articulation points and how you can take off the different pieces of armor and swap them out as you like between different Spartan models from this series. They had to get Master Chief right, and I think that they did. Out of all of the armor types, they got the 343 era mark, the upgraded Mark VI version here. It's just right. I don't think it could have been done better in this scale with the fully articulated new system. The pulse grenade, though, is weird. It's a little bit large, I think. Larger than I remember it being in game, and I really wish they had given it to us in transparent orange, because this is just a completely inactive version. But anyway, we got one. We might get different colors in the future and different sets. Of course, he's got his trademark assault rifle, and you can see a little bit of print here to represent damage on the armor. So a very good new Master Chief. And then there's full-sized holographic Cortana, who is not as see-through as before. If you recognize the figure for the most part, but something seems different about it, well, that's because it's using the same molds, I believe, as the original one. They just have not done it in a full transparent do-up this time. It's not transparent at all. Just used a powder blue with the finest detailing. Look at the lines. That is not accidental streaking coming out of the mold there. Those are actually printed on. Every single line, every single little detail you see there is intentional. That's phenomenal detailing for a mass-produced figure like this. Nice choice with the matte, fully non-glossy color for the hair. I think that was just a really, really good decision. I would not have thought to do that myself. Different legs. The legs are actually dark blue, but they're painted over with the kind of light bluish gray or kind of a slate color or something like that. It's a mist that's applied, so it's not even all the way around. Just a very well done figure. I wish that the eyes were applied a little bit lower. I know that the model that they used in game had a quite a long distance between the eyes and the mouth, but I feel like the strong cheekbones here, the strong jaw of this older cut, this older mold would have been a little bit more feminine, a little bit younger looking if the eyes were just a little bit lower. But still, phenomenal level of detail here. Not a whole lot of articulation with this one because you've got the fixed arms. You can't take that kink out of the elbow And this arm is just straight. You can move the arms straight up and down, but that's it for those. It's really designed to have the half akimbo. You've got ball joints down in the hips, and then just single straight joints for the knees to be able to bend. Overall, a pretty fantastic set, in my opinion. I think that for some hardcore fans, this set is worth getting just for the figures. Even if you're not a big fan of this, you still get a bunch of good pieces that you can use for customizing to do other things, but the figures alone almost make this set worth it. I mean, the Didact, of course you have to get Master Chief. A new Cortana, been quite a while since we've gotten one of those, and it was difficult to get when it was on the market at that, being a chase figure from the Mystery Pack series. The play value enhancements that they brought to the broadsword itself were impressive to me. The shooting missile pods, I was not expecting that. I think it's well executed. It's easy to use those. The removable warhead, the extra weapons that are stored inside, always great to get extra weapons that are not just going to be one for each figure that's included with the set. And there's just a lot of good stuff done with this, even though I personally am not a fan of the shape of the broadsword in game. It's so tough to do it with a brick-based system. Once again, please do leave a comment on the video with your thoughts about the set, and if you would like to put in your choice for which insignia for me to put on the tail, go ahead and post that up. If you would like me to put something different on the left than on the right, you can vote for that as well, but it's going to make it a lot harder for your decisions to be chosen if that's the case, because the chances of somebody, of multiple people picking the same combination is pretty rough. But go ahead and post up whatever you want, and whatever is the majority vote, that is what I will put on to this thing, and you will see it again in the future, I guarantee that. Thank you for taking the time to watch this video. I hope that you enjoyed it, and I hope that you'll stick around for more of my videos to come. Talk to you again soon.